Hello and welcome to the YouTube channel of Transition Career Solution. Today we are going to discuss ISC suggestions for your commerce paper for the year 2019. Your commerce paper comprises of 80 marks. You are allotted 3 hours for your ISC exam. Reading time is given 15 minutes. This extra 15 minutes time is given to read your paper carefully and to choose appropriate questions which you're going to attempt from your question paper. Now let's discuss the format of your paper. Your paper is divided into two sections, section A and section B. Section A is your 20 marks and section B comprises of 60 marks. Firstly, we'll discuss section A. Section A comprises of the compulsory portion of your paper. One question is there, that is question number 1. It contains 10 sub-questions of each 2 marks. So 10 into 2, which is giving you 20 marks for this part. Section A is basically your short answer questions. So please write the answers to the point. Do not try to elaborate things. Moving on to section B. Section B is, again I'm repeating, it's 60 marks. You'll be given 8 questions in this section. Out of the 8, you have to attempt only 5. Each question is comprising of 12 marks. The division of 12 marks is 3 plus 4 plus 5, which is equals to 12. Section B is basically your long type of answers, which is divided into 3 parts. So students, please choose your questions accordingly, where you can score more marks. Now let us see some of the chapters which you have for your syllabus. First chapter you have in your commerce is business environment. Second chapter is capital and fixed, that is fixed and working both. Third chapter is sources of finance for a joint stock company. Fourth chapter is banking. Fifth chapter is management. Sixth chapter is principles of management. Seventh chapter is functions of management and coordination. Eighth chapter is planning. Ninth chapter is organizing. 10 is staffing. 11 is directing. 12 is controlling. 13 is marketing, that is concept and functions of marketing. 14 is marketing mix and 15 is your consumer's protection. Now let us discuss some of the important questions for your this year's exam. These all questions are covering your 15 chapters, so student, nothing is from outside the syllabus. All questions, answers are present in your books. These are relative terms and relative topics relating to your text. Let's go through one by one. Question number 1. What is meant by macro environment? Question 2. Explain the importance of business environment in shaping the future of a business. Question 3. What is social environment? Enumerate any 3 components of social environment. Question 4. Explain 5 factors affecting the capital structure of a company. Question 5. What is the importance of finance to a business concern? Question 6. Explain 3 disadvantages of preference shares from the investor's point of view. Question 7. Explain 4 long-term sources of finance raised by a joint stock company. Question 8. What are public deposits? Give 2 advantages of public deposits from the company's point of view. 9. State 2 disadvantages of debentures from the company's point of view. 10. Explain 4 advantages of raising funds from commercial banks. 11. What is demand draft? List its 3 features. 12. Give 2 kinds of electronic fund transfer. 13. define management as a process. 14. Briefly discuss any 5 features or principles of management. 15. Explain Taylor's principle of scientific management. Last year's students, Fayol's principle of scientific management had come. So this year there's a chance of Taylor's principle of scientific management to come for your exam. But that doesn't mean that you're not going to study Fayol's principle, because sometimes it happens that Taylor's principle is given for a long answer and Fayol's principle is given for a short 2-mark answer. 16. Explain any 4 features of a budget. 17. Give 2 merits of delegation. 18. Give 2 points of difference between training and development. 19. Effectiveness of leadership depends on the qualities of the leader. Explain any 4 qualities that a good leader should possess. 20. Organizing is an important function of management. Give 3 points in support of this statement. 21. Explain the first 5 steps involved in the selection of a suitable workforce in an organization. 22. Explain any 5 points of importance of controlling as a function of management. 23. Management is the dynamic, life-giving element in every business. In the context of this statement, explain the importance of management in modern times. Sometimes it happens that you don't get direct question, you get a statement, and in the light of that statement, you need to explain certain points. 24. Distinguish between the term recruitment and selection. 25. Give 3 points of difference between Taylor's and Fayol's principles of management. 26. Give 5 differences between line and staff form of organization. So it is line organization and line and staff organization. 27. Name the elements of directing. 28. Explain the various steps in the process of controlling. 29. How is strategy different from policy? 30. What are the main features to be considered by the management while planning? 31. Discuss Maslow's theory of motivation. 32. State 2 types of products. 33. Give 3 differences between advertising and personal selling. 34. What is marketing mix? Explain briefly the element of marketing mix. 35. What are the objectives of personal selling? 36. Distinguish between marketing and selling. 37. Explain any 4 objectives of communication. 38. Discuss any 5 points of importance of marketing. 39. What is price? Discuss 4 factors that determine the price of a product. Lastly, number 40. Explain 4 methods of consumer's protection. So students, we have finally finished discussing the questions from your 15 chapters, which is a long syllabus. I have picked out some of the important questions which have a chance of coming this year's for your paper. Please go through them all properly. Learn your text correctly. Wherever there is a necessary, write the answers in point form for differentiation. Maintain table form of writing your answers. Number your answers properly. Leave line after each answers. Use a single color pen, either blue or black. Start your section B from a fresh page so that your paper layout looks more neat and clean. Thank you and all the best.